friend's evangelist, Rob, here at Rob Woods Ministries in New York, just a response to a pastor, Dana, who had really bore his heart via YouTube and all over a dream, a vision he has, or what he feels is coming to the earth. And friends, let me just suggest this. I am not an end times doomsday guy. I've never bore that mantle or candle. I'm an evangelist. Been on TV like 10 years in New York, 7 different secular TV stations, almost 49 shows a week, preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ. But the Lord absolutely came to me. I know he spoke and it shot my heart about 3 weeks ago. And he said, Rob, what's in this book that David Wilkerson wrote in 1973, The Vision, is coming to full fruition and manifest on the earth a lot sooner than you think now. For some of you that's familiar with the book, talks about the legalization of marijuana. Right now, we're obviously in race riots or race wars or coming off it, hopefully, due to the killing of George Floyd. And some of the radical protesters are saying they're glad gasoline is cheap. Now, in the book, he also talks about New York City being wasted and laced and burned to the ground. And, you know, that pastor did suggest it's going to get really bad this spring. But friends, let me just suggest this. In the prophetic, we should never try and go to a vision word or a dream, but they can and will come to us. In other words, we should never use encounters to establish doctrine. We should only use scripture to establish doctrine. So the timing of that dream, when it's going to come, obviously he is, it seems to be like the voice of a watchman, forewarning God's people to prepare themselves. But what can we do to thwart and maybe tame down what's coming, the shaking the Lord's going to allow on the earth? God in his sovereignty obviously allowed a plague and a pestilence to recently manifest. And many times when things aren't right in people's lives, they turn and run to the Lord. If everything's going right, let's face it, and the table's set and everything's perfect, many times we have no need of the Lord. It said you need eye salve in the book of Revelations, because you just need to come to Jesus. Everything's not right spiritually. Maybe in the natural it is. So when God shakes things up, like in Haggai, once more I'll shake not over the heavens and the earth, so only that Jesus remains. Because friends, I do believe we're going into perilous times, the beginning of the birth pangs, the great and terrible day of the Lord. Great if you're on God's side, not so good if you're not. The separations here, the wheat from the tares, the sheep from the goats, angels, demons, heaven, hell, light and darkness. There's no more grayness. There's no more on the fence. Either you're serving Christ or you're not. Like Elijah said, if God's God, serve him. If not, serve the devil. And I'm telling people to serve the devil, but you understand where I'm coming from here. We're entering into the beginning of sorrows. And I do know when those four horsemen begin to ride in that book of Revelation and those seals are open and those bowls start to spill over on the earth, I don't know who can stop it. But I do know prayer and intercession is one of the keys. I do believe simultaneously Isaiah chapter 60 says, arise, shine, your light has come, the glory of the Lord's risen upon thee, though gross darkness covers the land. Friends, the light shines the brightest in the darkness. So if that's the case, and there's great darkness and tribulation coming, then I'm believing there's going to be a great harvest simultaneously, an awakening and outpouring of souls coming into the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. Prophets seen a billion souls coming into the kingdom of God. And they've seen draft slips falling from heaven, Johnny, Susie, Mary, and young people taking the draft slips off the ground and listing themselves into the army of Jesus Christ. Joel talks about an army. They do not break ranks. Every man marches in formation. So when the Lord really spoke that to me about what's coming on the earth, it's not normal for me because I don't bear that. I'm not, you know, I actually shook me for about a day. The next day I asked the Lord to lift it. Because it's not a burden you can't carry, but it's pretty heavy, man. When God really speaks to you something that's coming and you want to weigh it out, you want to test the spirits, you just don't want to run with everything. We want to use discernment, believe what this man is seeing or what he's seeing is of the Lord. And many people do not want to hear it because they don't want to hear there's difficulties coming on the earth because it's unsettling to their life. your children, family life, business. It's, you know, you own a business. I'm a businessman myself. It's unsettling. It's difficult. So, friends, I believe we're seeing the acceleration of Matthew 24, the earthquakes and wars and rumors of wars. You know, Jesus said that. So what that means simultaneously, when you see more earthquakes and wars taking place than any other time in the history of man, you know it's at the door. Jesus talked about nation against nation, which is ethnic groups against ethnic groups. And the spirit behind these race riots is the spirit of hatred. And what's behind that is control and dominance and lawlessness. So friends, I'm just trusting the Lord. A mighty move of God's coming. The best days for the church are ahead. Hallelujah. I'm excited about the go. Jesus said, go ye into the world. Preach the gospel to every creation. Make disciples of all nations. Hey, thanks for the rant if you stood this, if you lasted this far. If you want to subscribe to my ministry channel, I'd be so honored. And you want to comment positive, just comment whatever you want. Hit the like button. The Lord loves you. Be blessed. Amen.